Hey guys, Roy Cabrera's, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool promo where I lost them off in one of the biggest Merseyside derbies in history. He picked up the win, and I won the Premier League trophy officially. I haven't gotten the trophy yet. They don't give it until the end of the season. But a trophy I can win is the FA Cup. As you can see, that is the focus of these last two episodes, really. Yes, there is only two episodes after this. There will be one episode. Whoops. After this, there will be one episode, which will contain the final of the FA Cup and the last Premier League game. I think that's against... It might be West Ham or something like that? I haven't checked, to be honest. I know the game after this is Crystal Palace in the league, and while it's not important at all to anyone ever, but it's a chance to get the secondary team out, give them a run out, see if they can maybe give some players a chance to impress. Well, it is the worst time. Because it's getting to the end of the season, so my brain is going 50 miles a minute about what I'm going to do with certain players. And you can see EDR semi-final, which isn't happening now. I'm on Saturday, so that Manchester Derby is on the Sunday. The final will be me versus one of them if I beat Spurs, of course. So it'll either be a fifth game against Manchester United, having faced them in every single freaking competition, or it'll be a fourth game against Manchester City, and having faced them in both English Cup Finals, the League Cup, and the FA Cup. I know there are other tournaments in England, but I'm not in them, so I can't be in the final of a tournament I'm not in. You can see my team line up. It's the main team. Spurs, I expect them to have the best team they can put out. Who we see, we saw a few moments ago, Christian Eriksen scored a hat-trick in his last game. Interesting. And yeah, as strong as you'd expect. Although Dele Alli, he rose, and there's a few players on the bench, but it's relatively strong regardless.
Well, this Wembley,
of course, no Harry Kane. He moved to Manchester United, if I'm not mistaken. Hugo Lloris, what the fuck is he doing?
Home, of course, to England.
Okay, let's just move on. Whatever the fuck that was.
The old one, much more.
Hope I can get a nice early one that will set the pace here. And possibly putting me into the final of the FA Cup and keeping me on track to win all three trophies that I can win in season one. And look at that, Hammers Milner scores the goal. Fantastic. 6 minutes in. Beautiful cross. Miller just sticks his boot out. Hugo Lloris is left looking stupid. And I'm 1-0 up. Fantastic. First goal in the FA Cup. Well, this is what, first or second game? So that's not exactly shocking.
Quick into the tackle.
Most of the main team have not played in the FA Cup yet.
Eriksen.
Because, of course, I had no reason to play him in the FA Cup until this point.
And that goalkeeper
can easily go through Karius. Look at that throw. I mean, it didn't go to my player, but it was a fantastic throw. A good ball save. Firmino, come on, Mr. Make the run.
Tackle here. The referee had a good look at that, decided it's just a throw after the tackle.
Roberto Firmino.
Penalty. Thank you.
Wow.
And normally Hamid Milner would be on the penalty, but I'm going to give it to someone I feel who just needs to get that first taste. Beast. Yeah. So Milner's not going to take this. I'm going to give it to David Alaba, if I can actually select it. Hurry. There we go. Oh, he sends Lloris the wrong way. It's his first goal in English football for David Alaba. There we go. Easy as that. I don't think it's going to be that easy with Nicolas Sewell, but Alaba sticks away the penalty. Not a bother. Right. We're looking good. Tuna pull up inside 15 minutes, around 15 minutes. Yep. His first goal for the club is in the FA Cup. Hopefully that'll, I mean, I'm not expecting a huge amount of goals from the, but I mean, he'll be the penalty taker. Or when James Milner is not in the team, which, unfortunately, is coming soon. In fact, he's probably only going to be a first team player for the remainder of this season. Unfortunately, because his overall has gone down this season, and it's just, it's against logic, even in the good form that he's in, it's against logic to have a player in your regular first team if he's just going to keep getting lower and lower rated, and I don't know if that's going to happen. I don't want that to happen. I don't want that to be the case, but I can't control that. So,
spotted the ball up and they're playing.
Unfortunately, Milner will probably play.
Ambitious try.
He's probably only got like. In fact, this is probably his second last game because he's not going to play. Because in the Premier League games in between this cup game, in between the semi-final here and the final, I won't be using my first team at all. It'll all be the second team just to get some variation of the second team anyway, just to get them some minutes and see if anyone can, like, maybe prove their status with the team, or maybe earn a move away, or whatever may come for them once the summer window is open. Because like I said it already, my mind is going a mile. Thinking about who's staying, who's going, who am I getting to bring in to fill those slots. Do I need any players to fill those slots? What am I going to do with some of the lone players that are coming back after at the end of the season? It's all... Hold on up there. And plus, I have to.
Only in that it's impairing a bit.
I have to put that aside and focus on the game. Because if I don't focus, Spurs will trash me, and
here we've got a free kick.
Can't let that happen. Looks like Milner might have accidentally injured Eriksen. Here comes Dele Alli, not exactly something you expect to be on the bench, but he's gotten on now. In unfortunate circumstances. And Christian Eriksen will not be adding to his hat trick in the last game. But Dele Alli might score! Ooh, he was very close. For his involvement in the game, he almost put Spurs back within one goal. How close can you get without scoring?
Coutinho. Trying to stretch the opposition.
Sadio Mane.
Now he's looking for some support.
This is the ball on Trippier, will clear, but it's going to come to Matic. Coutinho.
3 minutes.
Elmar.
3 minutes.
Nathaniel. Go on, Nathaniel. Yes. Ah, oh, Wanyama. I knew. I kind of had a feeling he was going to tackle me, but I was hoping I would get away from him with my, with Klein's pace, but that didn't happen. There's half time. Let's jump straight into the second half. I'm not making any substitutions, and yeah, they're not either. They did just make a forced change, so I don't think Pochettino is too keen on using a second substitution so quickly. Might wait till like the 65th minute or something around that. I don't know. I don't know how he thinks.
Good defending.
Fine. Please, if I can get a third goal, I'll be in a bit. I'll have a bit of breathing room, as it were. Sadio Mane.
Emre
Chan.
In this part of the pitch.
Going Nathaniel.
Here comes the cross.
Good. Well, Trippier got there before. Hello. Some time today would be great, Lloris.
Victor Wanyama. It goes out wide again. Quick into the top.
Ah, Heung-min Son wins the throw off Nathaniel Klein. Hey, but Davis makes a mistake, and there's a substitution. Moussa Dembélé is on for Victor Wanyama. So, an offensive substitution, very much an attacking midfielder on for a defensive one. So, two really offensive midfielders in Dembélé and Ali that they've brought on and have Pochettino on Spurs. Means they are going for broke. I'll make sure that they go broke. Daniel Sturridge makes it 3-0 and makes their substitutions very irrelevant. Ah, beautiful. Well, just snuck it in. Thank you very much. In off of Lloris and all. Oh, he hit like a shin pad, probably. He's gone in. It's his first goal in the FA Cup. And, yeah, as I said, the breathing room is real. I suppose I can get why they did bring off Wanyama. They do have Dyer still on the pitch as a defensive midfielder option. But now they have two central attacking midfielders on the there very much suffering for that. Oh, Milner should have made it 4-0 there. Come on, James. Come on, win the header. Yes, no, he didn't win it. So, Coutinho. Come on.
There's good progress with this attack.
Where are you going? Oh, thanks for the corner. Coutinho. Milner. Sewell get hit to Firmino. Go on, Roberto. Oh, for crying out loud.
One of the players that we really thought at the start of the game would be the sort of guy we're talking at the end for the right reasons, but we might not mention him in a positive way, the way he's played today.
Well,
he's
too. Whoa.
I'm sure he's
defenders and midfielders will be demanding a bit more, a lot more perhaps, from this attacker who needs to start hitting.
I was close to intercepting that. I probably should have.
Coutinho.
It's too. No, wait, take it quickly. He is still out of position. The Tonin is way out of position. What was he doing? Oh, and Davis, rookie. And covers. Wait. I still don't see him. Motherwell is there. But Vertonghen is gone walkabouts. He's up here! Why is he up here? Or you're not a striker, dude. You're a center back. I mean, he's up there on goal. I mean, he scored against Liverpool in the past. Twice, in fact, in the past. Yo, he should be back stopping things like Sadio Mane being clean through on goal. Oh, it's 4-0. It's game over. Spurs are out of the cup, and they have only themselves to blame. Because Vertonghen went walkabout, and he left the door wide freaking open. And Sadio Mane just said, thank you very much, I'll go in here and just score. And, yeah. Enjoy going out of the cup. Sadio Mane, one-on-one, it was never in any doubt that he was going to score. I think Hugo Lloris is probably thinking at this moment, he's like, shit, where the hell is my defenders? I mean, I don't know if Vertonghen could have kept up with Sadio Mane, but I mean, God sake, a center back shouldn't go walkabout and let a striker like Sadio Mane, the best striker in England at the moment in the game,
target for Liverpool.
You shouldn't just waltz away and let him clean through on goal. He's almost through again. He could score her misery compiler. Her. It's one for Spencer Owen. And there's the full time whistle. No misery compilers needed. It's Spurs, I feel, are very miserable. Regardless, they have well and truly been beaten. It could have been only 3-0, but they decided to let Sadio Mane have a goal too, because reasons? I can't think of any good reasons why they would let that happen, but they did. So, yeah, interesting. Interesting decision you made there. For Spurs. Now, who will the final be against? Will it be against Manchester United or Manchester City?
Middlesbrough 2.
I'll do the training. Simulate. It's probably going to come up in the news flash anyway. So there's no way of avoiding it. When I simulate, it'll tell me. So, the final of the FA Cup will be in Liverpool versus okay, it's not gonna tell me, and you can see I Fayard? Cedric accepted a contract offer. He's finally 16. And Coutinho signed a new contract as well, because he's happy at Liverpool. Well, don't believe what you read. It's all lies. Is Barcelona are not doing anything. And that's exactly what people who want Liverpool fans to think. If we think that, they win. The trolls win if we think that. Okay, Jamie, you gotta tell me who I'm playing in the next round of the FA Cup. Damn it. I can't check fixtures on days I didn't play. Manchester City, so I'll be playing Manchester City in a second final again this season. So it'll be another her trophy won in front of Raheem the scumbag Sterling. Instead of winning it and rubbing it in the face of Mourinho. I can live with that. I was secretly kind of hoping it would be Manchester United because it would have been fun to have that over them. But, well, what can you do? Anyway, spruce up the team for this game a bit. Grujic can't play in any other position, can you? No. I mean, he can play Cam. It would mean I would be playing with one striker. I'm gonna give Fayard his debut. Sorry, Ojo. But you're not in any immediate issue. We're not. I have no doubt I'm keeping your account for next season. You know what? Grujic can play in the I'll rotate the team accordingly in the following games. But this is the team that will play against Crystal Palace. Is this away or is this a home? Oh, this is at Anfield, so this is it's not even an issue. If it was at Selhurst Park, I might have an issue. But, no. It's not even an issue. Not even an issue. Don't worry about it. Action. Second last Premier League game that you're going to see of the season.
The game today, Liverpool against Crystal Palace.
Some,
undergoing a real
see what the second team can do against Crystal Palace. Some of these books. Here's our save. Some of these players may be loaned out or sold in the summer. We shall see. Oh, wow. My young player. He's got number 9. Who gave him number 9? What? Why? Why number 9? Why would you give him number 9?
Spotted well by the defender. Cut it out. Played down the wing. Keeping the wide attack going. Good forward play from them.
Having the number 9 shirt, or at any club, let alone Liverpool, is a big fucking deal. And you just give it to this random youngster. I mean, if he can prove himself, I'll let him keep it, but I don't know.
They cope with it well defensively.
Yeah, I have a few big men in the middle, like Lopez. I think I'm going to be able to neutralize Crystal Palace's aerial threat pretty good. Although, some people do that pretty well in real life without any big, relatively big men. The fact that we scored from set pieces and they didn't is very unusual. Alright, we score with a header.
He's such a strong player, very hard to stop.
3 goals in the Premier League already. Maybe from where he hasn't played that many games. It's good.
It is an advantage for Crystal Palace, and they're going to try and take advantage of the referee's decision.
Ah, that was a terrible pass. It's not number 9 stature. No? I realize I'm playing a left wing or a left mid, but it's pretty much the same position. What? What was that? Put the ball in the back of the net for... Oh, you've got to be joking me. Oh my god, I hate that. I press circle to tackle the ball off from the player. He picks it up, and the ball comes to my player, and it immediately tells Tawara that I want him to have the hope, and completely fail and look like a complete ass in the process. Yeah, that's really what I wanted to do. Well, look at him avoiding the challenges like nobody's business. Oh, and Dan. Who is from Liverpool and supported Liverpool as a boy.
Credit for taking on the shot. But well, what a good chance.
Apparently.
By his standards, that's a glaring miss.
I bet secretly he's very delighted that guaranteed to win the Premier League title. That's also happening now when he is matched, but actually, no, it's not. I've already won the league. So it's not in the slightest winning. Helping to win this match. I'm winning this match. It's just something I'm doing because I like to win. Diwara! Ah! Now that time I did tell him to shoot. Because I knew Mandanda would either parry it or push it out for a corner. And he did push it out for a corner. Ah, and I can't connect with the header, and there'll be another corner.
And he's up for the header!
So, or not, because Brannigan's header is terrible. Seriously, dude, what is...
...get there with this lead still intact. The away team come here having drawn their last two games.
Brannigan's one of those players I want to see something good out of in the next couple of games. Not just this one.
James MacArthur. Johan Cabaye. Read the play well to intercept.
Alexander Arnold.
3 minutes at least. On the attack.
Oh, yeah. Penalty! Come on! Yes, thank you. It's Dan as well. I lured him into the challenge. I saw it. The way he was running, I knew he was going to go for the slide challenge. That's why I turned. And so it would look like more like a penalty, and I would almost guarantee get it. And I did. I did get it. Now, who is going to take it? 69. That's not very good. But that's the best. Oh my god. Rivermar. Ah, oh, saved by Mandanda's stomach. Him in the stomach. And it's gone out for the corner.
But the goalkeeper's done well.
Well, there's not much pressure on a keeper. You're not expected to save it, and that's working.
Well, Mandanda will not need any dinner tonight. Right. He's full of, well, of leather, or as it were. This is one-sided. It's as one-sided as you can get. And somehow it's only 1-0. I hate these kinds of games, to be honest.
Rodwell.
When you're dominating a game and you know you should be winning it by like 4 or 5 goals. But the keeper's just had one of those days.
There's good progress with this attack.
Opportunity now. Moya, brilliant. 2-0. Well, that is something spectacular from the youngster. And it is 2-0. Oh. I saw Mandanda was coming out, and of course I went for the chip. Because he just opened the door, and I said, thank you very much, chip you. Ooh, lovely 1-2. Ooh, with his strike partner Rivermore. Mandanda made the mistake of coming out, and there was no one there for the cup. Ever for the chip. I mean, it would have went straight into his hands if he hadn't just fell on his ass like an idiot. I mean, what was he doing? He just, oh, fuck.
Johan Kabay.
He fell like a fucking asshole, and he's just, yeah, he's been made to look like an asshole. And he's recently been downgraded by EA.
Need
to reflect Crystal Palace in his bad performances. In general.
Quick.
I mean.
Make a note of this particular date. EA Sports, we've got.
And then there was a very good keeper for when he was back in France, but this is not France, is it? Premier League is a much different animal.
Defender to it first. It's good work between these two. We've had an hour gone here, and still 30 minutes left. Here's a chance to attack.
Ayur. I just know I'm saying his name wrong. Oh, it's come to Moya for the hat trick! Oh, he didn't put in! He kind of like rolled it.
Cross comes in now. That's safely away.
Alexander Arnold! What a save by Mandanda. Fair! Alexander Arnold! The lean back effort does not produce the goal. Brennigan. Ah! Of course he lost it.
Still 20 minutes to go. Bit of pressure on the player, that's why it's gone out. Good forward play from
Moya.
Crystal Palace are going to make an alteration as a substitute coming on. Out of play for a throw.
Thank you, Mark. Nice ball in. Gonna come into some way, yes? Brennigan! How? Just how? How, Connor? How?
And what about Crystal Palace in their next game, Ellen?
I don't even know. I really don't.
I can only see one winner, I think, now for Coastal.
Yes, Rivermore. If he can get past Tompkins, he'll be clean through. It's another penalty! What an idiot! What has he done? What has he done? And it's a straight red card. I mean, he can have absolutely no complaints. It was just a stupid challenge.
That was an easy decision.
I mean, there is only one person to take this. Sorry, Rivermore, but you've already missed one, to be honest. And while he has 37 penalties, Moya, from the spot, gets the hat-trick. Mandanda went the exact same way as I did the first time. And this time, just to make sure it was in, I went straight down the middle. I don't normally go straight down the middle. Well, I like to pick a side and stick to it. That's what you're supposed to do. But I stuck to the middle, period, because, well, his penalty stats are just garbage, but, you know, he got in the net, and that is the hat trick. I mean, that is what normally happens in real life. If you're on a hat trick, normally, and there's a penalty, you normally will get it. Unless it's some unusual circumstance. So we're trying to give me another penalty. What is he doing? mean, that could have easily been another one if he wasn't careful.
Fabulous clearance.
Fair! Ooh! I still don't know how to pronounce his name. I will learn for next season. Actually, he might play in the next episode, so I'll learn for the next episode if he's playing. I'll learn anyway by the time. I'm going to record the second episode.
Joel Ward. Ward shows three added minutes.
Steal from Mark. Brick ball for Alexander Arnold! Straight Mandanda.
Today.
Yeah, well, he's got pride to think about, and he doesn't want to get beaten, does he? Even though his team are...
There's the full-time whistle. Oh, Moya's hat-trick. It separates the two teams. It's fantastic, Victor. Yeah, I picked up two penalties in that match. That's one was saved by Mandanda's stomach, the other, her stuck down the middle. Well, after Tompkins was sent off for his foolishness.
It's good to...
Oh, I was just about to say, it's good to know Moya can just, you know, just put his hands through fucking leather. Or as if no big deal. Well, because those Premier League balls are hard, yo.
Liverpool.
Especially if it's fully pumped up. Oh, it'll sting like a bitch.
At the top of
the that's the end of this. So, a very good episode. In the next episode, I will have the final game of the Premier League season because I'll play these last league games. Wait, what? Oh, yeah. I was close. West Ham are near the bottom, but it's Middlesbrough. Middlesbrough are the final game. So there's three games you won't see. Let's be honest, I probably can't win them. So thanks for watching. Come enjoy, smash the like button if you did, subscribe if you're new, and until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.
And then reading up the table, second bottom, Watford with 31 points. Third bottom, Southampton with 32 points. Fourth bottom,